What is up, everyone? This is Justice, and today I am going to do a life stories about my jobs. And I've done a life story about my jobs before, but that was only when I had two jobs. I have been through many more now at this point. That recording was 4 years ago, or about 5 years almost. Anyway, let's jump in, guys. When I was 19, I finally got my first job, and I was basically just grasping for straws. I was trying to find any job I possibly could. There was like this little plaza by my house down the street from my old house. And there was a bunch of stores. I applied at Petco, and then I applied at Dollar Tree, and I applied at Smith's. And in the end, I went with Dollar Tree because it just seemed like a nice and a good place to start because it was a small retail location. So I started off at that job, and I started off getting paid $7.25 an hour. That is the federal minimum wage. That is the minimum wage in Utah. I was working maybe like 20, 30 hours a week. I first learned the cash register. I was a damn good cashier. And then they put me on stocking duties. And so, you know, basically, if you work a job that's minimum wage, you're either a middle-aged woman who needs a little bit of extra income, or you just want to get out of the house, or you're someone like me that's a kid just starting out, just 19 years old. So basically everyone there was a middle-aged woman. They had families. They were pretty old. Some of them were, you know, probably early 60s, late 60s, whatnot. And they put me, because I was the young guy, the only guy. There was one other guy, but he never stocked or anything. Anyway, they put me on the heavy lifting stocking. So I was doing the plates and glassware. I was doing the chemicals, which I hated. Anyone would hate stocking chemicals, especially at Dollar Tree. You get the worst shipments possible. I was also on drinks and basically just houseware stuff. But I would do every aisle except for the cards. I did not know how to do the like Christmas cards and holiday cards. But I learned how to unload the truck, stock, and everything. I worked there for like 8 to 9 months. It was a good first job. I got a solid I got solid retail experience out of it. And then I decided to go big time. I went from part-time, which is like, you know, 20 to 30 hours, to full-time. And this next job was working under the Affordable Care Act, or Obamacare. I'm going to tell you what that job was like. So under the Affordable Care Act, the government was basically, they did this thing called an individual mandate, making it so everybody had to buy into health insurance, or you had to apply for Medicaid, which is state-run health insurance, federally funded state-run health insurance that's basically free for low-income people. Huh? Basically, you needed health insurance or you're going to get fined on your taxes. Some people were exempt, some weren't. Anyway, the Affordable Care Act really did a lot of good. If you guys have ever heard about it, you've probably heard a lot of propaganda about it, that it's bad. It's definitely not the best. They could have gone further, but they introduced free community health centers. They introduced, like I said, state expanded Medicaid, where the federal government would pay 90% of the Medicaid charges and the state would pay 10%. It was good. And I worked under Obamacare in this call center where training was awesome. You know, I had a lot of cool people in there, but mostly everyone quit within the first 3 to 4 weeks. And I got out of training. I was doing a really good job, but you got to understand, this was a really high stakes call center job. It didn't, you know, it might not sound like it, but if a customer service representative like myself, if I made a tiny error, a human mistake, I could have cost someone their health insurance entirely. I could have cost someone tens of thousands of dollars in healthcare costs. It was really high stakes, and that meant people were pissed off at you all the time. All the time, people were mad, screaming and yelling. So basically, the main point of the job was to, We had to learn right away how to talk people down and say, listen, I know you're angry. I know, I understand you just waited an hour and a half to 2 hours on hold to get to me because you have to, and now you have to go through the Affordable Care Act website, which is terrible. I understand that, but you know, if you're calm, then this will go a lot more smooth. And so basically it was my job to talk people down and, you know, get them to chill out and then try and find out what health insurance plan was the best for them and what fit their needs. It was a crazy job, but I quit that job after 2 to 3 months because it was crazy. I had this phone call from this lady, and I'm not kidding about this, where she was the only survivor on her on a plane crash, only survivor, mad survivor guilt, okay? And one of the customer service representatives before me had accidentally made a mistake and got rid of all of her health insurance benefits. So she got a bill in the mail for tens of millions of dollars because she gets surgery constantly. She's barely functioning. She was crying so bad, I could not understand what she was saying most of the time. But that, after I got that call, I walked out. I can't do that job. I can't deal with the repercussions, and I can't allow myself to be the punching bag for our government when they fail to provide healthcare as a right to people, even though every other country can do it, every other major country. Anyway, after that, I didn't work for a while, but then I got this call center job. Basically, I was selling phones and phone service. I hated it. I had applied for this place called BioFire. BioFire is a huge company, and the problem with BioFire is they have this nepotism policy. So because my brother worked in the manufacturing department, it's a really good position. You're getting paid like $16 an hour, full-time, full benefits, day one. Since my brother was working in that department, I could not work in that department. So I had to apply for the janitor department. Bruh. Now, the janitor department at BioFire screwed me over in more ways than one, but mainly that I wasn't even an employee of BioFire technically. So they had this really crappy like introduction where basically you are hired by a third party company, and then after 3 months you can put in your resume to get hired on fully, and then it took another month to 2 months to actually get hired on, and then you get your benefits. I'm talking like literally, and this was a night shift job too. If you've ever done a night shift, you'll know what I'm talking about. But I would go in at work around 10 p.m. and I'd stay until 6 a.m. It screwed me up, not only adjusting to that time difference, but the fact that I didn't get lunch at night. I had to go eat McDonald's, which was nasty because I couldn't bring my own food or anything. So had to eat McDonald's. And then I didn't get any benefits. So I was working for a company full time, not getting any benefits, which I'm pretty sure is actually against the law. But there's a lot of loopholes and whatnot. Anyway, that job, I ended up quitting after I sent in my resume after 3 months because I was like, screw this. That job was also really high stakes. Now, BioFire is actually one of the leading companies in Utah and in the United States, Western United States right now, who are providing coronavirus tests. And so they've got all these labs and everything. I was in charge of cleaning the laboratories. You have to basically suit up in 100% PPE gear, where you've got a mask, you got a goggles on, you got a hairnet, you've got, you don't have your normal clothes on, you've got scrubs on. And I had to clean that entire laboratory at night when everyone was gone. And it was hard because if you miss a spot, it's a big deal. It could become a contamination. And when there's a contamination, they have to shut down production, which loses the company tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands of dollars in product. It was a high stakes job. I quit. I dipped out of there. If they had given me benefits to begin with, I would still be with them. It's a great company. But yeah, anyway, after that job, let me think. So I moved to Colorado. Oh, wait. Okay, so I totally skipped over Colorado. So BioFire was after Colorado, and then Colorado was after Obamacare. So I had moved to Colorado to be with my ex, and I had initially started working at this pet supplies company. And this pet supply store, I thought it was going to be a great gig because there's animals there, and I love animals. That's my thought process going in. Eventually, I found out the manager has no idea how to run not only a pet store, but a business. So we were basically managers taking control of the entire place while he was talking to customers, not doing any work or whatever. I was stocking the dog food, the cat litter, and the cat food. Most of the time, I was basically on everything, but mainly the heavy stuff. My other coworker was actually an assistant manager and ended up quitting as well. And my other assistant manager ended up quitting as well. And then once they both quit, I quit too because I had hurt my back stocking because they had this giant shipment. And this giant shipment, they expected me to complete in one night. Even if I had three people with me, we could not complete it in one night. I ended up hurting my back. I couldn't even get up in the next morning. So I called in and I told them, hey, my back's hurting real bad. I can't come in. They were giving me a hard time. So I said, you know what? I quit. You guys, I'm not going to be exploited like this at all. No way. Once a company starts hurting you, nah, out of there. And so I got out of there. I applied for a job at 7-Eleven. I had that job for one day and I quit because it's 7-Eleven. You see hundreds of people, sometimes over 1,000 people a day. I can't do that. No way. Dollar Tree, I thought was enough. And that was maybe like 100 to 200 people a day. So I didn't end up going with 7-Eleven. And then after that, I got a job at Macy's. And basically what I was doing was I was stocking the home goods section. Because I had experience in home goods from Dollar Tree. And I would go in there really early in the morning, 4 to 5 a.m. And I would price everything out, make sure all the prices are right, put the price tag on all the items. And the thing that Macy's does is, the reason why they have an entire position dedicated to pricing is because they'll get these items that are quote unquote worth, like, you know, let's say it's a thing of luggage. It's quote unquote worth $200. And then they quote unquote mark it down to like $79, making you think you get a good deal when it's in reality not even worth $79. And so that's why there was that entire pricing department. While I worked there, I also worked a second job that both of them were part time. I worked at Dairy Queen. I worked with my ex-girlfriend, actually. She was my supervisor. So, you know, that could get weird, obviously, but it was just a bunch of teenagers working there. I learned how to make all the blizzards. I learned how to do everything. And then I moved back to Utah. So after I moved back to Utah, that's when I got that job selling cell phones, and then got a BioFire job. So fast forward another 6 months after BioFire, I apply to this place. And basically what they do there is they caption calls for deaf people. So, you know, if someone's deaf or hard of hearing, it's basically free for them to get this government service. And this government service is a phone that has a screen on it. It's a landline. It's usually always older people that are, you know, moderately successful and or upper class, upper middle class. And I listen into their calls and I repeat what the caller is saying to the person who is hard of hearing or deaf. I repeat it in a monotone voice like this. So the speech-to-text program, Dragon, can pick it up and show up as a caption for them. And it's really weird. I love the job, though, because I'm not talking to people. I'm just chilling, talking monotone. No one. It's not like the caller hears me or anything. And it's kind of a chill job. I love it. And I've been at that job for over a year now. I might move up in the company. I might not. I think I'm actually going to go probably apply to BioFire again because I think they have laxed their nepotism policy due to the recent influx of viruses and that have been killing a lot of people. Anyway, those are my jobs, guys. In the future, I hope to either be a teacher or maybe do something on YouTube or Twitch. I don't know. I also want to run for public office and try and improve people's lives. I'm really into politics. A lot. Some of you guys might know that if you've watched my streams. I'm really into biology. I'm majoring in zoology and I'm minoring in political science. So that's what I'm doing in school right now. So yeah, right now most of my time's with college, getting my general education stuff out of the way. And then hopefully I can get into a good college and get a good scholarship and all of that. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really appreciate it. If you want to check out some of my older videos, I've got a lot of sword fighting and just Roblox in general. Thank you guys so much for watching. Really appreciate it. Stay safe.